I made my first mitered cut on this box using a sled. And this is a miter sled. And the thing that makes it a sled is the fact that it has runners that guide it across the surface of the saw. You'll notice that this is different from the cross-cut sled in that the cut that comes through here goes all the way, where in the cross-cut sled it only goes partway, preserving the integrity of the base. So with this, I need a very secure, strong piece at the front to lock the front part together and then the fence at the rear. There are certain steps to perform before you make your first cut. I use the miter gauge first to do my test of the angle of the blade so that when I put the sled in place, the sled isn't going to be cut by the blade being slightly off in its angle, and that will help to preserve the sled's accuracy. If you start with thicker stock like this, it gives you a leg up, particularly on cutting very small miter joints for boxes. So all I've done is I've adjusted my table saw to approximately a 45 degree angle, and then I'm going to check. And sometimes you're just really lucky and things work. In this case, I have a little bit of work to do here, and the problem is it's a little bit too open at this side of the joint, the top side of the joint. So in order to remedy that, I have to make my angle just slightly more acute. So I'm going to line it up where it's making a fresh cut, and I'm going to tilt my blade just a little bit more. I'm going to make my cut again and try again. Now that's not too bad. I can't see any light through there at all. So that means if my joint is that perfect over this width, you know that on narrower stock it's going to fit even tighter. I just simply set the sled down in the runners, move it up, and I can see that I have to lower the blade considerably. So I'm going to make this box about 8 inches long, approximately. I'm going to mark that as my starting point, and there's 8 inches. That'll put this knot kind of in a nice featured place. I'm going to leave a little bit of space in there to make my saw curve, and then I'm going to make it another 6 inches long from there. So I'll just do this, 6 inches long, and that's going to be my side, and this is going to be my front. Okay, now if I take this, you can see I've lined that up so that this part here will line up with that. I'll make a mark here. Using this resawn wood, I'm able to match the grain at all four corners of the box. A little bit for the saw curve and another 6 inches here. And so you can see how, how do these line out? You see how they are like that? So my first cut's going to be in here so that I'll be able to make my front and back, and then my next cuts will be in here to finish it. The other thing I need to do is mark on these parts exactly where they go when the box is assembled. So this one I called my front. I'm going to mark it going like that with an F. So I've got an arrow that points to the top. This would actually be my left side, so I'm going to mark it with an L, because see, the front box wraps around to the left side. This is going to be my back, so I mark it with a B, and this is going to be my right, so I mark it with an R. My first cut will be made with the stock face down on the table saw, and so I make a mark there that's going to align approximately with the saw curve down here. And I'll do the same thing with the opposite side. Now, can you see what I'm doing here? How I've aligned that mark with this where the saw cuts. So as I make this cut, the blade is going to come up through there and across, and that will be my starting point. This is a left tilt blade, and if you're standing where I am, you look over and you see that the blade tilts to the left. Now, there are also saws where the blade tilts to the right. And the difference that you'll find in the technique is on the left tilt blade, you keep your stop blocks over here on the right side, and so as you make your cut, it's done face down and then flips up and over into the stop block for your final cut. On the right tilt blade, You do it just the opposite. You'll make your first cut over here and then flip it against the stop block on that side to finish the cut. I made my first mitered cut on this box using a sled. So I'll turn the stock over. I've got this mark so it goes on the back of the box. I'll take my tape measure, slide it over, and I'll make a mark at the 8-inch mark. Now from there, I can align this with where the blade passes through the back of the fence, right there, and then adjust my stop block and tighten it down, and that should be ready to cut that piece. I just hold it securely with both hands and pass through the cut. And that's the back of my box. I put the front piece in place, align it against the stop block, and now I'm ready to make that cut. Now my front and back are exact, equal length. Okay, now I'm going to cut the first miter on the box ends. So I flip it over. So the face side, the outside face is down. And I'll turn on the saw. I'll do that one. I'll do the same with this. So now the next thing I need to do is simply set up the stop block for my next cuts. And so this is going to be at the 6-inch line. I make that mark. I position this in alignment with my cut on the back of the fence, and I'll slide the stop block over and clamp it firmly in place. And so you can see now I'm ready to cut my two end pieces. Perfect matched pair. And a perfect matched pair, we know the angle is good. So I can take these, set them out right, left, back, and front, and I can begin taking them, putting them together. Sometimes I put tape at the corners just to see how they're going to look. And with just a little bit of gentle pressure, I've got a box.